What's happening, everybody? And in this video series, we are building a generative AI chatbot exactly like ChatGPT 4.5 Turbo, but on steroids. ChatGPT literally on steroids. Why? Because we are personalizing it. Plus, we are giving our GPT a voice and we are giving it ears. Now, in this video, we are actually going to be giving it a voice. So without further ado, if you want to check out the previous video where we got started connecting to the generative AI and giving it a prompt via text and receiving a text response, just check out the previous video. Otherwise, don't forget to like this video. If you're feeling friendly, pop me something into the comments. Don't forget to share this with your friends and family. And if you're enjoying this kind of content and you are not following me, please do hit that follow sign as it motivates me like crazy. Like, that's enough chitty chat, guys. Let us get started. So previously, as I said, we connected through the Google Generative AI API and we gave an input and got a response. Now, we need to download and install the library PyTTS X3. So to do that, just head over into a terminal, ensure that your virtual environment is activated, and then we can go ahead and install the library. So to do that, you simply want to type pip install PyTTS X3. Great. Once that is installed, then we can import library which we've just downloaded by typing import PyTTS X3. Then what we can do is that under the completion stage where we gave the variables and the prompts and everything, just skip another line and there we can add TTS underscore engine. So we're creating a new variable and we're going to initiate our PyTTS X3 library. So to do that will be equals PyTTS X3.init, open and close our brackets. Now, once we have received our response, we want it to speak the response. So to do that, we're going to say TTS underscore engine, the variable which we just created above. We're going to pass that TTS engine dot say, open our brackets. And in there, we're going to give exactly what is in our print statement as well. So in there, you just want to go completion dot result. Then lastly, we're going to process and play the speech command by typing or passing the TTS engine variable which we created, and we put dot run and wait and open and close our brackets. And then that's literally it. But just check what happens now when we run it. Now we need to enter the prompt. So since it's holiday season, let us ask, what are the best places to visit in South Africa?
Cape Town is one of the most popular tourist destinations in South Africa.
Okay, but now you see there's this asterisk nonsense. Now that's not how a human speaks. So now we're going to have to fix that. So how are we going to fix it? Firstly, we are going to remove all of the code which is from the print statement. So get rid of that. And then we're going to create another variable which will take all of the asterisks or the star sign out of the text before it speaks it to us. So to do that, we'll create the variable spoken response equals to completion dot result dot replace. We can open our brackets and in our single inverted commas, we can put the asterisk, the star sign, then comma still in our brackets, and we replace it with nothing. So you put two empty inverted commas there. Now once that is complete, we can retype our print statement. So it will be print, open our brackets, and we'll pass it the variable which we just created, and no longer completion result because we are replacing the asterisk. So it will be print spoken response. Right, so that will print out the response, and now we want it to speak it again. So we'll pass the TTS variable which we created above, TTS engine dot say, and the variable which we just created, spoken underscore response. Now lastly and finally, we can process and play the speech command by typing TTS underscore engine dot run and wait. Please note that the and W is capital letters if the command does not already come up for you in VS Code. So, and then we open and close our brackets. Now let's try run that again and see what happens if it's going to sound a lot more like a human. Let's check it out. So as we run our program, we need to enter the prompt because we haven't given it ears yet, because we're giving it a voice first. So let's give it a prompt again. Let's, what are the best places to visit in South Africa? Please give me only two places. So then it's not too long. Let's see now.
Cape Town is a beautiful city located on the Cape Peninsula, at the southern tip of Africa. It's known for its stunning scenery, including Table Mountain, the 12 Apostles, and the Cape Point National Park. Cape Town is also a vibrant city with a rich culture and history. Kruger National Park is one of the largest game reserves in Africa, and it's home to an incredible variety of wildlife.
Now, how incredible is that? So now we have given our own generative AI, like ChatGPT 4.5 Turbo, but on steroids. Why? Because we have just given our own generative AI a voice. So next, we are going to be giving it ears so then we can actually speak to it and receive it back as a voice command. So that's for our next video, guys. If you enjoyed this video as much as I am, I'm so bloody excited, you have no idea. Please don't forget to hit that like button. If you're feeling friendly, pop me something into the comments. Share this with your friends and family. And if you're not following me and you're enjoying this as much as I am, don't forget to hit that follow or subscribe. Until the next video, guys, cheers.